Well, another fine semi-final we just saw, the women's singles. Chen Xiaoxin coming through in fine style. But it's women's doubles up next. Angia Shita Awanda and Mahadewi Istriani Nikatut made their way onto court from Indonesia. And their opponents from Malaysia, Vivian Carmoon Hu and Woon K Wei. So our umpire, Mr. Chung Jung from Taipei, with the all-important coin toss. Couldn't quite work out the result, but we'll soon see in a moment. Vivian Hu and her partner, Woon K Wei, ranked number 12 in the world. They've been up as high as 9. And the number 2 seed here at the Macau Open. From Malaysian, her partner here, Woon K Wei, the left-hander. years old from Selangor. And their opponents from Indonesia, who were looking fantastic in yesterday's quarterfinal. Angia Shita Awanda, the 22-year-old. They're currently ranked 16 in the world, unseeded here at the Macau Open. Her partner with the longest name in today's semi-finals, Mahadewi Istriani Niketut. Also 22 years of age. So this is the fourth time these two pairs have met. The Malaysians lead their head-to-head 3-0. Their last meeting there was the quarter-final of the Indonesian Open. And I don't think the Malaysians have ever dropped a game against this pair. There's our umpire, Mr. Chung from Taipei. And Summer Adnan from Iraq, the service judge. Vivian Hu on the left there, getting herself fired up. She is perhaps one of my favorite players in the world to watch in women's doubles. There are quite a few, but
ladies and gentlemen,
Vivian Hu seems to make doubles look very easy indeed at times.
And the honorable Angia Shita Awanda Mahadewi Istriani Niketut, Indonesia.
Welcome to the
good opening rally, except the miss hit on the block from Vivian Hu. Good smash from Kertut, but unfortunately her partner couldn't finish it off at the front of the court. Well, this is great opening to women's doubles. Good power from all four players. Attacking pressure from Awanda. Splitting the defense of her opponents. Vivian Hu and Woon Kei Wei, left and right handed, will always cause some confusion down the center of the court. Good touch of the net from Kertut. Good attacking pressure. Well, it seems the Malaysians do have their work cut out for them today. They looked in full control yesterday in the quarterfinals. Playing almost casually at times, but doing enough to get through that match. Good judgment. Yeah, the Malaysians just starting to find their range, looking a little more comfortable at the front of the court. Causing some problems for this Indonesian pair. And they're back in front at 7-6. Yeah, great play from Kertut at the net. She looked to the skies as she can't believe she missed that opportunity. It's a good performance this year for the Indonesians, though they only made it as far as round two here last year, where they faced a very tough Japanese pair. It went to three sets. They didn't quite have it. They've done well to make it through to this year's semi-final. Oh, great return of serve. Good disguise on the backhand from Vivian Hu. And the momentum shifted two or three times in the first half of this opening game, but it's the Malaysians that take us to the break. 3 points ahead at 11-8. Left. Well, the Indonesians definitely finding some success down the center of the court. Always causing some communication problems between the left and right-handed pair. Great pressure though from Woon Kay Wai. She made her own luck then. Miranda with that forehand drive.
10-13.
She meant to keep it as low as possible. Okay, it caught the net tape, but I never say at this level of badminton you're lucky to do so necessarily there. trying to keep it as low as possible, so there is a high chance you'll catch the tape on occasion. Too much time on that drop shot though. But the error in the rear courts, leaving it so late from Ketut. Slight misjudgment. And Vivian Hu was very aware to put that away. Yeah, well left. 15-10 now.
15-10.
The Malaysians will keep the pressure on to close out this opening game. Oh, well left.
16-10.
Woon Kei-wei was committed. She did quite well to pull out of that shot. This time they get it right. Better judgment on the back line. Oh, that's brilliant. Vivian Hu is a frightening prospect to take on at the front of the court. Great net player. Great all-rounder, really. Another example. Quick to jump on anything loose at the front of the court. And Woon Kei-wei this time with the straight smash that doesn't come back. Must have been a broken string there, perhaps. Yeah. Nevertheless, it's the Malaysians that advance with a 9-point lead, serving at 20-11. The clash of rackets. And game point saved by the Indonesians. Another change of racket, this time Vivian Hu. So, just 8 points to save for the Indonesians. There's one.
13-20.
but it was too much of a challenge. And it's the Malaysians that take the opening game, 21-13. Well, it was a confident finish to that opening game from the Malaysian pair. Well, it's a shame. It was good defense from the smash of Vivian Hu two or three times, but in the end, the error from Awanda. And one more change of rackets, either a string or a problem with the grip, perhaps. Vivian Hu made her debut here at the Macau Open back in 2008, 8 years ago as a junior. 16, one of her first senior international events.
4-1.
And she's been playing the Macau Open almost every year since, which is really great to see. Common name in major events, these two Malaysians. They're often seen in Super Series and Super Series Premier events, not tending to advance much past round 16 and quarterfinals, but at Grand Prix, Grand Prix Golds and the like, they do tend to make it through to semi-finals and finals. They haven't made a final for quite some time, however, so This might be their weekend. Well, the Indonesian defence held up for quite some time. It took a lot for the Malaysians to find a way through, but in the end, a very fine smash down the line from Vivian Hu caused the breakthrough. Yeah, good cross block. A cross drive from Awanda. So much like the first game. The Indonesians well in it. 5-3 in front. Good attacking play from the Malaysians. Oh, it's called in. Well, called in by the line judge, I think, but overruled by the umpire. That cross-court smash did seem to drift wide. No real complaints from the Malaysians. Great defense from Woon Kay Wei. Just turning the shuttle around the net. Great skill and touch on the defense. Good enough for a return of serve. Straight onto the forehand of Vivian Hu. And there seems to be moments in both of these games where the Indonesians turn it on and somehow get a run of points in quick succession. This seems to be one of them. Great defense from Woon Kay Wei. Oh, and the same can be said for both Indonesians. Oh, great touch, well played. And a good finish to that rally. Might have been the longest rally of the match so far. Umpire saying enough's enough. There haven't been that many long rallies in this match. Better start to this opening game for the Indonesians. Quickly halting that run of points from Malaysia, but we're not quite there yet. Good attacking pressure from the Indonesians. They found holes in the defense of the Malaysians two or three times in that rally.
11-8.
And they've done enough to take us to the interval. They lead this second game 11-8. Well, we saw some good attacking play from the Indonesians in the first half of this second game. The Malaysian pair will not want to let this one run away from them, however. But they need to get back on the attack. Their defence was looking a little shaky at the end of that first half. And there's two quick points for Vivian Hu and Woon Kay Wei. Ketut looking very determined. It's impressive the fighting spirit we see between these two Indonesians. They will not give up without a huge fight. There's that left and right-handed problem. Both of the Malaysians going for the shot. Back. Well, what a great rally. And finished off in fine style by Awanda. I think Woon Kaye-wei, as well as the rest of us, didn't expect that second early smash to come back. But it did, and there's a good example of the fighting spirit of these two Indonesians. Three points the lead, still 14-11. Oh, that's great. Well, I like the rotation of the Malaysians just then. Using that left and right-handed combination to their advantage on attack. Oh, and a great stop drop from Woon Kaye-wei. Really nice attacking display from both Malaysian women then. Judgment well left.
13-14.
An important rally. The Indonesians allow this Malaysian pair back to within 1 point. Defense. Yeah, some great judgment. Vivian Hu leaving that to drift wide. Impressive stuff from Vivian Hu, re-lifting all of those smashes. A difficult skill to get the length so consistently off a number of smashes in a row.
Thank you.
bad judgment. Difficult. She was well in the court when she left that behind her. Never in doubt, really. Oh, it was the Indonesian's turn this time to keep relifting smashes. But it was one too many. That one drifted wide. Slightly surprised at the complacency on defence from the Indonesians then. With a chance to go 2 points in front late on in this second game. I would have thought they would have tried to turn defence into attack. They looked a little flat-footed in the last two rallies. Disappointed. The Malaysians were in front for the first time in this second game, but very briefly. Indonesians back with the serve at 17 all. Some help with the net cord. But Vivian Hu smiles at that ridiculous smash. Such a miss hit. Better pressure from the Malaysians. They looked very alive in that rally. Staying low, driving flat. Forehand lift drifts long.
19-18.
Indonesia stay in front. Just 1 point. Oh, what a great return of serve from Woon K Wei. great confidence at such a crucial point in the match. The Indonesians desperate to take a game off these two Malaysians. And the mix up once again from the left and right-handed Malaysian pair. Forced Vivian Hu very late. I think she was right to believe her partner, Woon Kay Wei, was going to jump out on that forehand, but game point with Awanda serving. Oh, good defense. But great attacking pressure from the Indonesian pair. And it's Awanda and Ketu that cling on to that lead and take us to a third and deciding game. It's one game all. So the Indonesians managed to hold their attack well enough in that second game to stay in front. And again, that pressure down the center of the court. Causing some problems on defense for the Malaysians. Malaysia finding life a little uncomfortable out there at the moment. Too many errors. Forced errors will allow them to say, but yeah, there's another one. Good attacking pressure from Indonesia, but in the first game, these shots were coming back. A quick run of points, the Malaysians requesting their court mopped. I think just as much to break the momentum of the Indonesian attack.
Three, four.
And there we see one service error from Awanda. One return of serve error from Awanda. And suddenly from 4-1, the Malaysians are back to within 1 point at 4-3. Great power from Ketut at the back of the court.
5-3.
Good backhand from Awanda. And there we go again.
6-3.
I'm not sure I like the body language of Vivian, who at the moment she seems frustrated with her partner, or perhaps them as a pair, their defense. There's a constant confusion down the center of the court. That miscommunication has been the cause of so many points in this match.
Seven, three.
And suddenly Vivian Hu looking somewhat rattled out there. Woon Kei Wei trying to G up her partner. Awanda and Ketu still looking very determined, very aggressive. Mindset, that confidence, such an important factor. On paper, at least, these Malaysians are the better pair, but
9-3.
They seem to be crumbling under the pressure here in this women's doubles semi-final. Great attacking pressure again from Ketu and Awanda. Oh, I like this a lot. Awanda looking very calm and composed. And Ketu backing her up. These Indonesians have finally found their form. Playing with a certain freedom now. Looking very relaxed. And it's all to do for Woon Kei Wei and Vivian Hu of Malaysia. Yeah, Kertu sensing the urgency in the situation. Two very quick points from Malaysia. The Indonesians had a 7-point lead. Although they'll be looking towards the interval, they won't want to give away any free points.
6-10.
But that error in judgment. Allows Malaysia one more, serving at 6-10. Oh, great return. Oh, great stuff. Well moved in from Awanda at the net. It's the Indonesians that seem to be doing all the attacking so far in this third and deciding game. They've got a 5-point lead at 11-6. Well, it's crunch time here in the women's doubles semi-final. The Indonesians serving at 11-6. One game all, the third final deciding game. Awanda and Kertu have been very impressive so far through this third game. Looking very organized, very composed in attack. The Malaysians all too often leaving gaps in their defense. Oh, great drop. And a great finish. They do rotate very well when they're in attack, the Indonesians. Well, it's a fantastic display this third game for Kertu and Awanda. They seem very fired up indeed. Consistently on the attack. And playing some great shots as well. Defense from Kertu. She left her partner in a hole briefly, but she managed to claw her way back into it. And this fighting spirit I mentioned earlier really has given the Indonesians so much confidence. And after a promising start from Malaysia, it is all doom and gloom now. 10 points behind at the end of this match. Awanda serving at 16-6. Well, it's just great play from this Indonesian pair. Vivian Hu and Woon K Wei looking lost at sea at the moment. They just don't really understand what's happening out here. Well, that's much better from the Malaysians. I haven't seen them in attack from the rear court for quite some time in this third game. They need to regain their confidence and get back on the attack, but for me, 10 points behind. I don't think it's going to be possible. Ketu with the drive, clinging on to the back of the court. And nothing's going right for the Malaysians now. It's 19-7. Doesn't look like the Malaysians were expecting this match to go to a third game. But they didn't hold it together enough in the second to deserve it. And what a great return of serve, the backhand cross net from Awanda. And an unbelievable scoreline. Awanda and Ketu serving at 20 points to 8. It's match point in Indonesia. Oh, and they got too confident. Well, they'll need to save 12 points, 12 match points, the Malaysians, if they're to get through to tomorrow's final. They've saved one. They've saved two. But surely 10 more is beyond them. Match point down. Match point number 3 to Indonesia. Good return of serve. And that's all it takes. Awanda and Ketu, what a performance in that third game in particular. Massive fighting spirit in the second to cling on to that small lead they had all the way through. Fully deserved win for the Indonesians, and it's them that take a place in tomorrow's women's doubles final here at the Macau Open. Fully deserved, match won by Ketu and Awanda. 13-21, 21-19, 21-10. Well, three semi-finals down. What a fine display, especially in that third game from Awanda and Ketsut of Indonesia. It's men's doubles up next.